went to uni in Brighton, basically Patty put up a sort of like a musician's ad online and to want to start a pop punk band. And so I replied to that, and then we found our drummer Foley, and then I went to uni with our bassist Ali. Worked out nicely.
Yeah, eventually fell into place.
I think to have grown up with a label like Fearless, I mean, I've listened to Fearless bands throughout my entire childhood, to be the first UK band to sign to Fearless, like a label that I respected for like my entire childhood, is like surreal. We're so attached to our own music, so to have fans that care so much about what we do is very odd and very wonderful. Yeah. We love the internet, we love our Twitters and our social networks and all that stuff, so it's just, it's very weird when you go and play Prague and there's people that know your band, or you go and play somewhere you've never been before, and but that makes everything seem so much smaller, so it's reception worldwide's been amazing. It was quite late in the writing process that we wrote Dial Tones.
Yes.
So we'd all been missing our girlfriends very, very much, and it was a huge kind of weight because it was impacting their lives and our lives.
We locked ourselves away, literally 3 months writing over the summer.
So Dial Tones is about, like, I guess, the detrimental effect of distance and guilt of removing yourself from someone you love's life.
The title of the album is Never Happy Ever After, and it's 11 sad songs.
Yes.
Yeah, pretty much.
We recorded it in Florida at the end of last year with James Paul Wisner. He's done like Under Oath and Dashboard Confessional, so working with him was, you know, those are some of my favourite records, so getting to work with him was an amazing experience, and the record just turned out so much better than we could have anticipated going into the writing process, I think.
Yeah, he worked as hard, but the result is, it sounds great.